crazy.
Yeah, word. Definitely.
Word up. All right.
Yeah.
So we go from first. So we go from First Family for Life, and then you'll get to Loud Records, Warriorz. You know, at this point in time, Loud Records is a pretty big label. You know, they had the Woo, you know, whatnot, and they were making moves. Pun, word, Mob, Pun. So was there a big like anticipation for this album? Was there like a big like, you know, because the record was a big record, Warriorz. You know, Annie,
yeah.
Up, Cold as Ice. You had really big stadium type, you know, anthem songs. Like, was this like on purpose? Because, you know, everyone was like, oh, this is gonna be the album to put you all over the top.
I don't know. I think every time we got a new situation, you find new energy.
Mm.
And, you know what I mean? You find new energy. You got new plans for what you're gonna do. And it's like new excitement. So I think that kind of make you come out with the record that you come out with.
Right.
That was like your coming out party to me. Like, you had like a lot of production credits on all the albums, but yo, that Cold as Ice, my nigga, that shit was ringing like a motherfucker when that shit came out.
Though.
Yeah, well, like, were you just like sitting around and that Foreigner sample came on, or like, how did that shit come about?
I tell the story all the time. One day I was walking, me and ladies going up to the label and shit. We was going up to the label or whatever. It was raining and shit. We meet up and shit, walking down the block. And Manhattan, you know, people throw furniture out. That shit be looking brand new and shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? They throw shit
this
out. I seen the records. So back then, you used to collect records. You had to go to record stores to buy shit before the fucking
right.
YouTube and shit. Word. So I seen the records. I snatched them up, threw them in the bag, took them home, let the shit throw out, whatever. And I found them shit.
Wow.
I didn't know who Barnes was or nothing. I just knew the sample. Well, I just liked the sample. At the time, we had just did a song. We had just did a feature for Mark Ronson, you know.
Oh,
and I ain't know that was. So when he heard Cold as Ice, he said, "Yo, my pops loved the record. When y'all doing a video, you want to come down?" You know what I mean? And I ain't never know that was a step pop and shit. And I wound up telling him, like, I ain't know who Foreigner was. I wound up telling the old man that shit.
Wow.
Yeah, nah, it's just like, when I didn't realize, like, you know what I mean, how powerful was. I'm like, yo, I, you know, I just like the fucking record, so I said,
yeah, that's off the chain. What so, about
Andy Up? That's Mark Ronson's stepfather.
So, oh, word?
Yeah, he made that happen, too. Mark Ronson made that happen and shit.
So there was no problem clearing that shit?
Nah, it wasn't.
Nice,
that's
nice.
Crazy. Yo, Mark Ronson's a crazy producer, too, yo.
Another
record you produced on there was Calm Down, yo. You know what I'm saying? Talk about that one, because that was some serious shit right there.
Calm Down, that's another thing. We was in the studio, just locked out, man. And the record was in the studio, so I just, you know, when you got time to spare shit, you just go through shit, try to put something together. Like, making beats is just like playing fucking video games for me. It's fun for me. So,
so
I just wound up throwing the record on and throwing the drums with it and shit, hooking it up. Well, but really, Primo makes the shit out of it.
Oh, where?
Yeah, Primo mixed the shit out of that one.
You know what's crazy? The way he mixed it almost had, like, if you heard it and you didn't know better, you would have been like, yo, Primo made that beat? You know what I'm saying? It definitely gave it that, the mix gave it that kind of vibe, yo. You know, what's ill also about the album, yo, y'all work with Knots, you know, who's a legendary producer from Virginia.
I got some new shit with Knots. It's crazy. So Knots is bad as a motherfucker.
Word,
what's
this,
M.O.P. album or
huh?
Fame album?
Nah, Fame album.
Oh,
nice.
Yeah,
nice.
We got some M.O.P. shit too.
Okay, that's what's up. But yo, that Home Sweet Home, yo. Lord have mercy, yo. You know what I'm saying? That, you know,
Lord
another Brooklyn native.
Yeah.
Yo, he murdered that with y'all. Yo, how'd y'all hook that shit up?
Lord, that's good people, man. He's family, so he always hanging out. Him and my nigga Lays used to hang out a lot or whatever, so he wanted to come to the studio. Actually, he bought that beat. He bought the beat, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about Every Day? Who was him playing on?
Oh, man, I love that shit.
The G&B product?
Yeah, G&B. That's Primo. Primo picked him. He's like, yo, you know, I used to like that fucking Santana record.
Carlos Santana.
So,
And I met them before
we closed up the album. So we needed somebody for the hook on that joint. So Primo was like, yo, you fuck with Fuzz G&B? I'm like, yeah, I just met them niggas, they good. You know what I mean? So That was like one of the last songs that was on the album.
That's a dope record. Right.
Yeah, and they came through and released that shit.
Annie Up. Right, we got to talk about Annie Up, B. Transcends, probably your biggest hit. You did that. You did the production on that.
Talk about
the making of that record and shit.
I didn't do the production on that. DR did
no,
that.
No, DR period.
Oh, DR
period.
Did it?
DR.
Okay, my fault.
Yeah,
so
DR what happened was, we ain't speak to DR in a minute, man, because DR been moving around or whatever. And just once we got that deal with Loud, I'm like, I definitely got to pass by his crib and shit. I was running around looking for music and shit, so I stopped by his crib. And one thing about DR, he have a bunch of shit, and he just got to sit there and go through it, you know what I mean? Because he'll skip through shit. Like, he tried to skip that beat. I'm like, nah, bring that shit back.
Wow.
Yeah. Like, that one? You sure? Yeah, I like that beat. Give me that fucking beat. That was when niggas, you got to wait until a nigga make a tape for you and shit. you know what I mean? So I picked that, and I picked, Kill him, background niggas.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Background niggas on Warrior. I picked the Andy up and shit, yeah. So we went
what about
that,
the
right?
Remix? Was that like a D&D type of situation again, or
Nah,
with the Remix and Busta and all them?
We recorded that at Pyramid.
Okay.
Pyramid, and then we mixed it at Unique. Unique Studio.
Okay.
In Manhattan. Yeah.
Nah, so Busta was playing from the beginning then for the remix then?
Nah, him and Lays. Him and Lays went in the studio. Just Lays was like, yo, I got to, Busta did a verse for it. You know what I mean? Then we wound up doing a remix. You know what I mean? And Remy got on it because.
What about Rem? Yeah.
Yeah, Rem Pum is my nigga. Pum is my heart. You know what I mean? That's my good friend before he passed. But, you know what I mean? When Pun threw us on his album, the Yeah Baby album and shit.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. I love
that.
Nah, New York Giants.
Yeah, classic.
And
I met Remy there and shit. And I knew that was Pun's artist. So after Pun passed and shit, she was gonna the A&R was like, yo, throw Remy on the joint. She on Loud Records. And shit. I'm like, yeah, sure. Let her rock. You know what I mean? She did her thing on it, so we kept that. But we was getting, when they heard it was going to be a remix, Annie Up coming out, man, we got calls from every fucking way. You know what I mean? Like, every artist trying to do
everybody wanted to be on
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
We got
different versions, too. We got another version, but we even have I can't remember the name right now. Master P Brother, what's his name?
Oh,
the one who's locked up?
Yeah. No, not Silk Shocker, the other one.
See Murder?
Huh? Yeah, see, Murder, we even had a version of him. So.
Crazy. Yo, who else, Rob, done that shit?
Tef, we just kept it to Tef, us, Remy, and Busta. We just kept
shit,
like that. Yeah, but
did that
huh?
shit blow up organically, or did like that, was that like, because I felt like that record just blew up by itself. Like, you know
I think, but that record jumped over. Flex was on that record, so.
Right.
So that's, you know, he gonna spend that shit. But it's his.
Right. He's always,
well, it was on his, it ain't his, but it was on his project. You know what I mean? So he gonna spend the shit out of it. It's a lot of people do versions, but I don't wanna throw nobody out there like that.
Right, I got you. Yo, another ill producer on that project.